Look at this. It's a graph of reported car thefts in the US from 1990 to last year. It's been coming down on the whole, but what's happened in the last 5 or 6 years? It's increased. Are new cars easier to steal, or is something else going on? Let's go. I'm no detective, and there could be a number of reasons for recent uptick in car theft. COVID definitely didn't help when a considerable amount of people began working from home, leaving their cars parked for days and weeks on end without using them, and thieves were able to pick and choose their targets like they were shopping in the supermarket. And due to new car shortages, many used cars have seen a dramatic increase in value over the last 18 months, making them hugely popular among criminals looking to make a fast buck. Whilst increased security with modern systems caused the initial drop in thefts, could it now be making modern cars easier to steal? On some older cars, all a thief needed to do was smash a window, find the ignition and power wires, touch them together, and they'd vanish into the night. And they literally did that in every movie ever. These old techniques of manipulating ignition wiring are used less and less due to improved manufacturer and aftermarket security. But of course, as car security has adapted, so have car thieves. And there are two types of car thief: the opportunist and those that pre-plan. The opportunist is easily deterred with good security measures. They're the ones looking for a quick and easy theft. They'll be searching for car doors left unlocked or keys in the ignition. And they're usually either using the car to commit a crime or just fancy a joyride. And you might see that car again, but it won't be in the same condition as when you left it on your driveway. It could either be involved in a police chase or left in a field or a side road somewhere, sometimes even burnt to get rid of evidence. And then the pre-planned theft is far harder to prevent. Have you ever seen the movie Gone in 60 Seconds? It basically works like that, except it probably won't be Nicolas Cage doing it. And these thefts come from the dark and dangerous realm of organized crime, and are usually referred to as stolen to order. They tend to target higher value luxury cars like Range Rover SVRs, Audi RS3s, Golf R's, BMW M3s, stuff like that. So why do they want them? The obvious answer is money, and thieves can't just go and trade in your stolen car at a dealership without all the correct paperwork. After all, it's not Grand Theft Auto. And that's why they usually either dismantle for parts or even sent abroad, where they'll be harder to track. And no, they don't all go to this big car heaven in the sky, and we've covered where they go in this other video. You should watch that. You're sure to have seen plenty of videos online where these cars are literally driven off driveways by thieves, and it's easy to then think that car theft must be at an all-time high. So what are the actual figures? It's good news that car theft has been reduced by more than half in the last 30 years. In the UK, there were 89,000 reported cars in 2020, which is just 132 thefts per 100,000 cars on the road. And it's a similar story in the US, where there are 246 thefts per 100,000. And again, I'm no detective, but I would expect that the recent increase, you know, the one in 2020, is down to the fact that cars are just worth more now, meaning thieves are more motivated to go and steal them. And the higher car price prices are down to COVID making silicon more expensive and harder to come by, then the manufacturers can't get it and they can't make enough cars, and that's a whole other story. Anyway, it's likely that the rise of social media and viral videos means that the shock value of a car being stolen is just exposed to us more. And when Joe Bloggs had his Mark 1 Golf stolen from his driveway in 1975, he probably didn't have the personal CCTV or mobile phone to record what happened, poor guy. But put simply, just because you see it online more often doesn't necessarily mean it's getting worse. But despite that, it's alarming how thieves are still getting hold of modern cars so easily. Just take a look at this. So how did they do it? Modern cars open up a number of possibilities for thieves, with two of the most popular methods being relay theft and OBD theft. And let's look at how they work. Manufacturers usually have good intentions when implementing a feature on a car. And what was a good idea on paper sometimes has serious flaws in practice. And keyless entry and keyless start systems are at the core of why modern cars are kind of getting easier to steal. They work by sending an encrypted radio signal from the car's key fob to a receiver in the car. And this only works when you're close to the car, and it makes unlocking and starting your car more convenient. But unfortunately, it also means that it's more convenient for thieves, because it means they no longer need to steal your key to get your car. There's no smashing of windows, no alarms, and no fuss. And this is known as relay theft. So your car is sitting on your driveway outside your house, but your keys are inside. The car won't unlock because the key fob just isn't close enough. But our well-equipped pre-planned car thieves won't take no as an answer. They will actually use a signal booster to increase the range of the remote signal. The car then senses the signal, thinking it's nearby, and then unlocks. At that point, the thieves are out of there in your car. And yes, of course, once they get to their destination, the key won't then be nearby anymore and they won't be able to turn it back on. However, this sort of theft often falls into the pre-planned category. So thieves will usually have a route and a destination plan to get the car close to a chop shop or a shipping container. So what if your car has a keyless start but doesn't have the keyless entry? So if you have a push button start, but one of those flippy key things. Surely that fixes the problem. Unfortunately not. Most cars built since the millennium will have an OBD2 port. And in case you don't know, that's where garages or owners can plug in a car to carry out diagnostics or read and write to the car's ECU. So how does a car thief take advantage of this? It's much more intrusive than relay theft because basically they need to somehow get to the port. This will usually mean smashing the window to reach in. They'll then open the door and it'll set off a load of alarms. The thief will then quickly find the port, plug in a device into it, and then gain access to the ECU. They can then fool the car into thinking the key is present. This then disarms the immobilizer, switches off the alarm, and makes it easy to start up and drive off. And by gaining access to the ECU, they're then able to program a new key to your car. Again, this method will usually be pre-planned and it's the fault of organized crime. And these underground crime rings often have the equipment needed to make both an ABD and relay theft a walk in the park. But on a slightly more positive note, this does mean that the chances and opportunist thieves are less likely to try and steal a modern car as they won't have the correct equipment. This is all a bit doom and gloom, but don't worry, there are plenty of ways to help guard your car against theft or even help find your car if it's stolen. Manufacturers have had a go at improving their systems, with Ford introducing a new key fob that helps prevent relay theft. The fob has a sensor in it that detects when it hasn't moved for longer than 40 seconds and then puts it to sleep, making it impossible to then boost the signal to steal the car. That's pretty clever. And the aftermarket has many methods to keep your car safe too. Physical locks like steering wheel or pedal locks have been popular for some years now, but most can be chopped through with heavy cutting tools. A popular solution to OBD theft is to simply relocate the port itself. If you relocate it some obscure place like under the boot lining, the thief is going to be looking for it for a while. And with the alarm going off throughout, I expect they'll clear off before they find it. And for those keyless entry cars, a hugely popular method is to have an immobilizer. These have been a thing for a while, and they work by having a third-party immobilizer that requires the presence of either a fob or a code in order to unlock the car and start it. Modern immobilizers have become incredibly stealthy, making them undetectable to thieves. And some of them don't even need a physical fob or keypad, they just use the car's existing buttons to enter a code and then deactivate it. A Faraday pouch is another useful purchase for those with keyless entry. These pouches work by blocking this signal, so then it can't be boosted to steal your car. Though they won't prevent your car from being stolen, trackers are also very effective. When combined with a good alarm or immobilizer, it means that the chances of having your car stolen are low, and that the chances of recovering it if it is stolen are quite high. Thieves that steal a car to order will often leave a car in a secluded place for a few days just to see if it has a tracker and if anyone turns up to claim it. If then no one does, it's goodbye to that car. And there are many, many ways to prevent car theft and retrieve it once it's stolen, but it's basically impossible to prevent it altogether. To give you an idea of how brazen these organized thefts can be, listen to this. A couple here in the UK had their Audi RS3 stolen from their driveway at knife point. The car was recovered by the police just a few hours later, only for them to be immediately stolen back by the thieves from a police compound. They actually stole it back from the police. They wanted it so badly, they were willing to steal it twice. It's actually unbelievable, stealing it twice. Car theft is a horrible business, but just remember there's still a very low chance it'll happen to you. In fact, it's probably more likely you'll find a rust-free MX-5. I would know. No, don't put that in there, Jackson.
Oh God.
But should your car be stolen, it's worth knowing where it might end up. We made a whole other video about it here. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. You should follow us on Instagram. Do that. Do that.